Hi, and welcome back to Raising Rogers. The book that we're going to talk about today is called Anytime, Any Place, Any Prayer. This book is a part of the Tales That Tell the Truth series, and I've reviewed a few of those before. So this company and this series will be no stranger to you by the end of Raising Rogers. But this is by Laura Wifler and Catalina Echeverri. If you're a mom, you might recognize Laura's name. She and her sister-in-law actually do a podcast called Risen Motherhood that I highly, highly, highly recommend if you are a young mom. Risen Motherhood's fantastic. So she helped write this book. And again, it's the same illustrator as all of the Tales That Tell the Truth series books. So let's dive in. So this book starts out talking about Adam and Eve in the garden and how everything was perfect and wonderful. And they could talk with God about anything, anytime they wanted to. And everything was perfect and wonderful. But when the devil sneaks into the garden, he tells Adam and Eve, or he suggests to them, that God doesn't love her and Adam. And they believe this lie. And one of my favorite lines in the book, it says, they chose not to trust and obey God anymore. This is called sin. And sin spoils beautiful things. The book continues on. And it tells how before, when everything was so perfect and wonderful and Adam and Eve could talk to God about anything, it was great. But now that sin was in the world, they didn't know what to pray sometimes. Sometimes they didn't know what to pray, or sometimes they didn't want to pray to Him. And then sometimes they were just plain old scaredy pants about talking to God. It tells us that talking with God is called prayer, so it explains it very simply to children so that they can understand. But the book goes on and says that God kept reminding His people that He wanted to talk with them about anything, anytime, any place. And it gives these great examples of Miriam in Exodus 15 and why she prayed, and Hannah in 1 Samuel 1 and why she prayed, and then Jonah in Jonah 2 and why he prayed, and all the different reasons. One was for rejoicing, and one was for sadness, and one was for forgiveness, and how we could talk to God about anything, anytime, any place, even in the belly of the whale like Jonah was. It says God's people prayed many, many times. And then one day, God sent the Father, His Son, Jesus, to earth. And Jesus tells the people, while He's on earth, how to pray. He explains to them the reason that we need to pray to God and how we can pray to God, and it makes it very simple, and they explain the Lord's Prayer, and it goes over that in the book for the for little kids to understand. And so then Jesus explains to His disciples in the upper room one day that He has to go. He can't stay with them any longer. And of course His friends were sad, but He tells them, you can talk to Me anytime, any place, through any prayer. So Jesus goes and He dies on the cross and He pays for our sins so that the people could be with God forever. And it tells us that Jesus comes back to life and He goes to heaven and He sends His Spirit, the Holy Spirit, to be with His friends that He has been with for all these years. And it says now there was nothing stopping anyone from being friends together with God. It gives a similar illustration as before. Of Miriam and Jonah while they prayed. Well, now they give a similar illustration to kind of bring that same idea back. It says, Jesus's friends didn't ever have to be afraid of talking with God about anything, anytime, any place. It gives examples of Perpetua and Felicity, William Tyndale, Susanna Wesley, and John Perkins. It says that anyone who loves and trusts Jesus as their friend and King can talk to Him just like this. And then it gives that same illustration again. I love that it kind of repeats this idea of all the people throughout the years praying to God for all these different reasons. And so now we're in illustrations that the kids can understand, like things that they would be doing now today. It says we can pray to God when we want something really, really bad. We can pray when we need forgiveness, and we can pray when we need help to do the right thing. We can pray for friends who are sick. We can pray when we've had a bad dream. We can pray about adventures we want to go on and what to do with your really cool ninja moves. So, obviously, the illustrators and Laura have done a fantastic job of bringing prayer down to a level where these children can understand. And it tells us we can pray any place. It shows a picture of a car on the playground, in your bedroom, in your bathroom, by yourself with your family and a friend. And then the very last page says, someday Jesus will return, and His friends will live with God in His perfect, beautiful world forever. And we can talk to God face to face, just like in the garden. So I think this is a fantastic book that explains what prayer is and how through the ages people have continued to pray for different reasons and different things. But no matter where you are, what time it is, doesn't matter. We can always pray to God because He is always there waiting for us and listening for us. So again, this is Anytime, Any Place, Any Prayer by Laura Wifler, part of the Tales That Tell the Truth series. And I hope that you can add this one to your shelf. Until next time.